Good morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ. This Mass is offered for the repose of the souls of our beloved family members, and their names will be included during our Eucharistic prayer. In thanksgiving, special intentions and healing for Penny Charles, Ethel Penn, and Erin Simpson. In thanksgiving and special intentions for Alan and Vivian Pather. In thanksgiving, special intentions and birthday blessings for Haroon Abrams, Rowan Charles, Justin Dunn, Bruce Belay, Melissa Howe, Corrine Isaacs, Lenny Bowers on his 60th birthday, and Sister Maureen Tawil on her 81st birthday. Welcome to Mass. We are celebrating the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our theme this morning is Seduced by Christ. We ask you now to take a few moments to gather your thoughts and your mind and your heart as we prepare to celebrate Mass.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we cry to you all the day long. O Lord, you are good and forgiving, full of mercy to all who call upon you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, when we follow Jesus, we cannot avoid suffering. For us to experience the resurrection, we should experience dying. For us to be on Easter Sunday, we pass by Good Friday. And many a times when we face suffering, we become weak, we become afraid, we become cowards. Without God, we cannot be faithful followers of Christ. And so as we begin this celebration, let us ask God for his strength. Let us ask God for his assistance so that we may be faithful followers. And we confess the sins we have committed by running away from the cross. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my dear friends, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my most grievous faults. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins, and may he lead us to eternal life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Jeremiah. O Lord, you have deceived me, and I was deceived. You are stronger than I, and you have prevailed. I have become a laughingstock all the day. Everyone mocks me. For whenever I speak, I cry out, I shout, violence and destruction. For the word of the Lord has become for me a reproach and derision all day long. If I say, I will not mention him or speak any more in his name, there is in my heart, as it were, a burning fire shut up in my bones, and I am weary with holding it in, and I cannot. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God, you are my God. At dawn, I seek you. For you, my soul is thirsting. For you, my flesh is pining, like a dry, weary land without water. I have come before you in the sanctuary to behold your strength and your glory. Your loving mercy is better than life. My lips will speak your praise. I will bless you all my life. In your name, I will lift up my hands. My soul shall be filled as with a banquet, with joyful lips, my mouth shall praise you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I appeal to you, brethren, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may prove what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, enlighten the eyes of our hearts that we might know what is the hope to which he has called us. You. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. At that time, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things from the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. And Peter took him and began to rebuke him, saying, God forbid, Lord, this shall never happen to you. But he turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. You are a hindrance to me, for you are not on the side of God, but of men. Then Jesus told his disciples, if any man would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever would save his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. For what will it profit a man if he gains the whole world and forfeits his life? Or what shall a man give in return for his life? For the Son of Man is to come with his angels in the glory of his Father, and then he will repay every man for what he has done. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, this morning we have before us a special challenge, if you like, And that is to take up your cross daily and follow Jesus Christ. And I'd like to start with this question. What is the way to glory and victory in the kingdom of God? Jesus told his disciples that he must first suffer rejection, be crucified, and then rise again on the third day. In so many words, he explained that there could be no victory and no glory without the cross. And Jesus's prediction of his suffering and death on the cross caused his disciples great dismay and disbelief. Peter, who was often the first to react to whatever Jesus had to say, wanted to protect Jesus from any threat or even harm. And that is why he rebuked the very thought of Jesus having to face rejection, condemnation, and crucifixion. And immediately, if we reflect a little bit more on our readings this weekend, there are so many themes that come through. For example, we have a choice, my way or God's way. And maybe it starts with this question: why did Jesus use the word Satan when he addressed Peter? See, when Jesus went out into the wilderness to prepare for his public ministry, Satan came to tempt him to follow a different path than the one chosen by the Father in heaven. Now, Jesus recognizes in Peter's response another temptation to seek a different and a less costly path for accomplishing his mission more than the way of the cross. The word Satan literally means adversary. One who stands in opposition. Now Jesus reminds Peter that his role is not being an adversary, but a disciple. A disciple is one who gets behind his master to follow with trust and obedience. And the second theme that comes through quite clearly is the one of victory and glory through the cross. Jesus was the first to know that the cross was the only way he could ransom us from slavery to sin with the price of his blood, which was shed for our freedom. Through his sacrificial death on the cross, Jesus defeated Satan, who held us in bondage to sin and condemnation. And Jesus defeated the power of death and overcame the grave through his resurrection. Through his obedience to his heavenly Father's will, Jesus reversed the curse of Adam's disobedience. His death on the cross won pardon for the guilty, freedom for the oppressed, healing for the afflicted, and new life for those condemned to death. His death makes possible our freedom to live as adopted sons and daughters of the merciful Father who is in heaven. And then there is this paradox, the paradox of God's economy, if you like. Jesus told his disciples that they too must be willing to lay down their lives in order to gain the new everlasting life with the Father in his kingdom. And there is a certain paradox in God's economy. We lose what we gain, and we gain what we lose. When we try to run our life our own way, we end up losing it to futility. And only God can free us from our ignorant and sinful ways. When we surrender our lives to God, he gives us new life in his Spirit and the pledge of eternal life. You see, God wants us to be spiritually fit and ready to do his will at all times. Isn't it strange that when the human body is very weak or ill, we make every effort to nurse it back to health? How much more effort and attention should we give to the spiritual health of our hearts and minds? The great exchange is the next theme. What will you give to God in exchange for freedom and eternal life? Are you ready to part with anything that might keep you from following the Lord Jesus and his perfect plan for your life? Jesus poses these questions to challenge our assumptions about what is most profitable and worthwhile in life. In every decision of our lives, we are making ourselves a certain kind of person. And it is possible that some can gain all the things they have set their heart on, and only to wake up suddenly and discover that they've missed the most important thing of all. Of what value are material things if they don't help you gain what truly lasts for eternity? Neither money nor possessions can buy heaven, mend a broken heart, or even cheer a lonely person. The next theme is losing all to gain all with Christ. A true disciple gladly gives up all that he or she has in an exchange for the unending life of joy and happiness with God. You see, because God gives without measure, the joy he offers, no sadness or loss can diminish that joy. The cross of Jesus Christ leads us to victory and freedom from sin and death. What is the cross which Jesus Christ commands me to take up each day? When my will crosses with his will, then his will must be done. And in closing, are you ready to lose all for Jesus Christ in order to gain all with Jesus Christ? So I ask you to bow your heads as we say together, or I say on your behalf, the prayer of Ignatius of Loyola. Take, Lord, and receive all my liberty, my memory, my understanding, and all my will, all that I have and possess. You have given them to me. To you, O Lord, I restore them. All things are yours. Dispose of them according to your will. Give me your love and your grace, for this is enough for me. Amen.
Now let us stand and together we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let them take up their cross and follow me. God's word nourishes us, gives us strength and courage to live as God wants. Refreshed by its teaching, we approach our God for what we need.
For the gift to persevere in God's service, Jeremiah, the prophet of God, teaches that God's call is a call to service. May we be faithful in following God's way, supporting one another by the values we own and the truths we profess. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For I desire to discover God's will. May we always seek to find God's will in the church and in the community. And may we have the courage to be guided by God's call, seeking the perfection God wants in how we live. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For an acceptance of the cross, may we acknowledge the mysterious will of God, especially in times of trouble. And may we be generous toward others, carrying the crosses that life brings in our journey with Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For I desire to understand what is important in life. May we understand that God's ways are not our ways, and may we be concerned for what is of lasting value, so that God's plan for each of us may be fulfilled, bringing us happiness in doing what God wants. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all the sick, that they may be restored to good health, and for all those who have died, that they may rest in the peace of the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our own special needs, let us place them before God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
The prayer for protection against the coronavirus. Gracious God, we give thanks anew for your providence and presence. We prayerfully seek your grace amidst COVID-19 here and overseas. We pray for those in need of healing. We pray for your peace with those who are anxious or grieving. We pray you will continue to strengthen and sustain all those who are serving in response. We pray for your Holy Spirit's discernment amidst the many choices and decisions facing our national community and medical leaders. We pray we each might see quickly what more we can do to help those who are vulnerable. This prayer for our nation in the family of nations, with all that is in our hearts, we gather now and pray. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Loving God, you provide for us always. Deepen our confidence in your love for us and grant what we need through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
The humble spirit and crimes are read by you, Lord. My sacrifice be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, Lord, from my iniquities and cleanse me from my sin.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Thank you.
proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Wilfred Napier and Abel Gabuza, our bishops, all the clergy, the religious, and your entire people. Remember your servants, Victor and Raphael Louis, Angus MacPhail, Elaine Vernon and Michael Fuller, all the deceased members of the Fuller, MacPhail, and Curry families, Pa Sam, Ma Hazel, Libby Barrell, Jack and Louis Montier, Percy Keshua, Olga and William Peters, all the deceased members of the Finn, P.S. Curry, Manitz, Van Vogel, Madu, and Johnson families, Hester and Neville Prodell, and Bruce Gouveia. Whom you have called from this world to yourself, grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant you peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and work of the Holy Spirit, you brought life to this world. Free me by this, your most holy body and blood, from all my sins and from every evil. Keep always faithful to your commandments, and never let me be parted from you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are invited to share in the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Walk with me, pray with me, and talk with me. You're my brother, don't leave me all alone. Let us laugh together, cry together, live together, die together. I need your help, together we'll be strong, 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 strong. Take up your cross and follow me, Christ.
You're my brother, and you can see I've tried and tried again. Will you come with me, walk with me, pray with me and talk with me? You're my brother, don't leave me all alone. Let us laugh together, cry together, live together, die together. I need your help. Together we'll be strong, 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 strong. Feed my lambs and feed my sheep. Christ gave us this command. You're my sister, help me keep on trying and trying again. Will you come with me, walk with me, pray with me and talk with me? You're my brother, don't leave me all alone. Let us love together, cry together, live together, die together. I need your help. Together we'll be strong, 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 strong. Teach my gospel to the poor.
Christ gave us this command.
You're my brother, and with your help I'll try and try again. Will you come with me, walk with me, pray with me and talk with me? You're my brother, don't leave me all alone. Love together, cry together, live together, die together. I need your help. Together we'll be strong, 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 strong. Love and help your enemies. Christ gave us this command. You're my sister, help me please to try and try again.
Will you come
with me, walk with me, pray with me and talk with me? You're my brother, don't leave me all alone. Let us laugh together, cry together, live together, die together. I need your help. Together we'll be strong, 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 strong.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our parish notices for the 30th of August. The fathers would like to thank all who have been faithful to the giving of their tithes and also those that have given donations. It is greatly appreciated, especially during these very difficult times. And we pray that God may bless you all abundantly for your generosity. Finally, those celebrating birthdays or anniversaries during this coming week are invited to stand for a blessing from Father Ndodana.
Almighty and ever-living God, we give you thanks for the gift of these, our brothers and sisters who are celebrating, those who celebrate birthdays and those who celebrate wedding anniversaries. We ask your abundant blessings upon them. Make them realize the joy of being your disciples so that they may pick up their cross every day and follow you. Then may the blessing of Almighty God come down upon you and remain with you forever. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
God bless you today. God bless you today. God bless you and keep you. For many a day.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. And let us go in the peace of Christ to announce the good news of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and hunt shall be no more. When the ports of peace are open far and wide, and when all shall cease their fighting and shall build a brotherhood, then the love of Christ shall rule in every heart.
When the roll is gone up yonder, the roll is gone up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the rich and poor shall share the blessings of this world of ours, and the Lord shall wipe away our hates and fears. When the black and brown and white shall walk as friends upon this earth, then the love of Christ shall rule in every heart. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. For the beauty all around us here, our minds are full of thanks. For pure water and clean air, we breathe a prayer. When we use them and we save them for the children yet to come, then the search shall be a joy forevermore. When the roll is called up yonder,